Newcastle Arena for the Vipers' home game against Coventry, a friendly which at times seemed anything but. Wilson, though, says while winning is the goal, fighting does have a role in the sport, as well as being a crowd pleaser.
The whole game of hockey is a physical game. And it's just been allowed from day one that you know, you're allowed to fight, and it's part of the game. But it's like you just don't go out and just decide, oh, we're just going to fight. You know, there's reasons for it, and as coaches, you have to know when it's right for your team to fight as well. You know, there might be something happen during the game, and it might be a very close game with a couple minutes to go. You can't afford getting a penalty, and you have to be intelligent about these things.
The Vipers.
The play, and David Clark's in there, he's not backing down. Paul Moran's there ready to strut his stuff, or do you now? Tony Hand doesn't know which one of the two set twos to go to. Do you is corralled by Dion Darling. Dion Darling's not going to let the big NHL official heavyweight do any damage to his younger, smaller players. And here we go now, Dion Darling's throwing them. There's been a problem with the Edinburgh Capitals shirts. They're not tied down. Oduya, though, has to have his tied down if he chooses to fight. His shirt's coming off now, so that should be an extra penalty for him. Dion Darling's got him. It's always difficult to find a player when the gear comes out. For that reason, there's nothing to hang on to. Oh, Dion Darling's found something to hang on to. Aduya's throat. Well, that's unfair when a guy doesn't have his shirt tied down. Hopefully the referee will spot that, but perhaps not. Dion Darling doing his job, looking after his teammates.
Come on. minutes into the game, Coventry had just scored, and Jeremy thought he'd just get things going straight from the off. He chucked his gloves down and said to Coventry's David Kazoka, "Want some?" And, yeah, he did. And that's all their gear on the ice. That's the helmets, the, was it, elbow pads.
And that's perfectly legal.
So, right, they're going for it. Now, what do you reckon he got? 9-month ban?
At least.
A couple of £1,000 fine.
At least, yeah.
Yeah, sent, obviously, minimum, yeah. Sent off.
A lot.
Yeah.
Could have been banned for life, probably.
2 minutes in the penalty box.
I can beat that. This is fellow London racer Jason Norrie picking up an immediate one-match ban. Which was actually increased to 4 matches afterwards for lamping 7 bales out of that bloke there in the penalty box. That's the area they're in now. That's called the penalty box.
They gave him an immediate one-match ban, because that's what the commentator's saying.
Unbelievable. So what exactly...
Vipers import Matas Petrico, known to his teammates as the Slovakian Express. A great defensive performance ensured the shutout, and a fairly aggressive attacking performance landed Vipers hard man Andre Payet in a bit of bother. Bison's Michael Wales was on the receiving end. Both players were sent from the ice, but of course they were all friends again at the end.
Thank you. there's a hell of a lot of actors, and Garrow now getting involved, and he's taking no prisoners. Voss there. Voss having a scrap as well again with Bowen. And Voss, he gets the fall. And DeWall and Skiha holding each other. To number 15, Scalay and O'Brien, quite content just having a chat. There's equipment on the ice. Voss looks none the worse for wear. He's rolled his sleeves up ready for more. If you look at Bowen just coming into the sin bin, he looks like he's come off second best properly that time. Well, and there's good discussion still going on.
Walton on the ice for the Giants. First time tonight, I believe. Well, it's Walton and, well, another little ding-dong down there in the corner. Mihalik and Graham Walton. Walton, who scored his first goal for Belfast last week, having a little bit of a go. It's his first time on the ice and he's sees combat, as it were. Well, he's pulled his head off. Hat, not his head, but his hat, helmet. Vaughan got him in the face now. Well, a bundle to the floor. Well, who knows? It's been a bit like that tonight, Paul.
Yeah, it's been one of those nights where there's been a few fights. Young Walton did pretty good there against an import. Mihalik seemed to get the best.
Baker tries to bring it into the zone. He'll come in. Oh, he chapped. Slash Rod Saric, and Saric and Baker have a few words with one another. Baker's going to come back at Saric, and he wants to go, and he's going to try and spin Saric around, and these two are going to go. Baker throws a couple of lefts, and Saric just throws Baker into the boards, and still Baker's trying to throw. Now Saric gets one hand free. He's trying to push Baker away, and he's trying to get that helmet off. He's done just that. Baker, as they try and open up, Baker is pushing Saric into the boards. These two are having a good scrap here. Baker tries to switch up. Saric has got him in a headlock. Tries to take him down to the ice. Baker lands up on top. And Baker needed to do something to inspire his team here. And he decided the best way was to drop the gloves. And Rod Saric answered the bell for the Sheffield Steelers. A pretty healthy scrap. Pretty even on points, I think, in the end. So that on the puck, and it'll be a chance to break away.
Off for Cardiff. Goulet, a good playmaker, brought in this year. Now the gloves are off. This was expected. Here we go. Brad Voth going at it toe to toe. Well, new signing Jeremy Cornish was expected to get himself into this game early, trying to make a mark. 172 minutes in penalties last year for the London Racers. He's got his hands full with Brad Voth. Voth is 6'5", and he's no stranger to the penalty box either. This is a good match between these two guys. Both a couple of big boys out there. Voth, that right hand over the top, couple of short lefts. Little boxing commentary for you here. Voth takes a short one there he's not going to be happy with. Cornish just brought into the Newcastle lineup from London. This was expected. Trying to find his feet, trying to make his mark, trying to be accepted by the crowd. That isn't going to take long.
Easily in Coventry when the Blazers are under pressure. Coventry get it forward into the Panthers zone. The fans clapping down the last moments of the game. Shogren in the corner. Bielax nails him with an elbow in the corner. His feet off the ice. Shogren still down hurt. We haven't had a whistle. Now the Hooter goes. We can get treatment on there for Stefan Shogren. I think he's in La La Land at the moment. The players go around. Well, I can hear the scorer shouting, that was a good hit, that was a good hit. Watch, feet off the ground, jumps, 6'5". Depends how you define the word good. And now Bielak's at the Panthers bench. Coach Mike Blaisdell's involved. Everyone trying to get a piece of the action. Everyone standing up trying to get a better view. Well, Shogren was chirping at the Nottingham bench as the handshake should have been taking place. It's finished 4-4. Look beyond the incident to the halftime scoreline in the Challenge Cup semi-final.
It's 3-0. Two penalty calls against the Giants gave Newcastle the chance to get one goal back towards the end of the period during a 5-on-3 power play. And then another of the Vipers' heavyweights, Andre Payet, decided to have another go at Skihar. But once again, the Giants man not only got the best of him, but also escaped with a two-minute penalty when Newcastle were hoping he'd be thrown out of the game. The second period...
...around his players, rest of his team able to get into good shape. Shudra takes the shot, that's why they call him the Rocket. And a follow-up from Dudiam and Maxwell. Maxwell's having some afters with Michael Kiesman. Michael Kiesman trying to get his helmet off, but Maxwell's holding him at arm's length, and Kiesman's getting some good shots in there. Maxwell takes the moment to lose his helmet. Jerseys are coming off. The crowd are on their feet, and this could go. This is good play from Kiesman, but Maxwell gets a big punch in there, and Kiesman goes down. Maxwell hasn't finished with him, but you probably have to say that was a points victory. Maxwell, they got the takedown, but Kiesman gave a good account of himself. They'll both sit, and of course, this is the new Elite League. So they won't be getting 2 minutes. That'll be 2+2 for fighting for the pair of them. Lehman was quoted in the Sheffield Star as saying...
Play going on. Bielak and Dewaal squared up there. I think the crowd wanted it. Bielak wanted it. And there they go. Dewaal and Bielak. A few fisticuffs. They think Dewaal's too interested. He's more interested in the verbals, I think. Bielak wanted a bit of physical stuff. Voff will have a go at him, though. I don't think he minds. There we go. That's the fight the fans wanted. This is what's been brewing for nearly two periods. Voff and Bielak takes off Bielak's helmet. Can they get any punches away, though? Oh, the gloves coming off from Voff. He's getting a few punches in. They're firing against that plexi. The helmet in the face. Tables are turned a bit. Bielak standing up to the big man. Voff using his height, a couple of punches going in. Well, not really hard punches, were they? You'd want your money back if you paid for this fight, wouldn't you? Seriously. But Voff protecting his teammate, that's what he's there for. Didn't look too bothered about it in the end. And again, you just never know what's going to happen next. Walsh working hard in the corner there. Penalty against Regan Darby now, as he was hacking away at the man. There is Darby. There he is. And there we are. Like I said, the entertainment value continuing. Darby's quite willing to fight anybody, including the linesman if necessary. Manny's out there as well. Calder and Francis holding each other. But Regan Darby was a man possessed there. Regan Darby is the one who owns those two legs buried under the two officials. Well, Russ Cowley wondered what had hit him there. I think he knows now soon enough. And I think that could be the end of the night for Regan Darby. Regan Darby wants a bit more. I think that's called going out with a bang. It's Chris Brabham.
Doak will try and come away. The old flying dive there coming. And Robinson comes across, and this might be a stupid penalty for Robinson because he just skated right up to John Wheaton and straight-armed him. And now we're going to see the boys dance. Robinson drops the gloves, and he's having a bit of a scrap here with Ryan O'Keefe. The two grapple on the far side, and Robinson just trying to exert a little bit of toughness here. He throws a big left. I don't know how much that caught. Two of them just grabbing jerseys at the moment. He's just trying to get the left and get that helmet off. He's trying to rip it from the back. And these two making a bit of noise right now. I would imagine Robinson's going to be pretty tired pretty soon. As he keeps trying to get that visor off so he can throw some real punches into the head. But the chin strap's on pretty tight right now. And now Robinson is free to let some fists go. It's an arm free out of the jersey as well. And Robinson's got to be a bit wary of that because you can use a lot more leverage once that right hand is out of the jersey. And now they're trying to trade. And Robinson gets a couple of good shots. And already... we see O'Keefe just trying to back away, but Robinson ain't done yet. He's grabbing hold of the braces. These two are hugging, they're kissing. There's all sorts going on inside there. As Robinson's put in a pretty fair effort, as is O'Keefe. Good right inside, and two good rights, actually. There's that uppercut that was awesome. And these two are having a real good battle out there. I think the linesman will get in there now. It's a pretty good scrap, Mike Perron.
Not bad at all, not a bad scrap at all, but... Unfortunately, I'm not sure how the penalties are going to come out of this. Robbie already had one on his way to the penalty box when he picked up the fight.
Yeah. It's energized the building, though.
Definitely. People are on their feet.
Apart from you and I.
Apart from you and I.
That's because I'm too lazy and you get the excuse of a bad foot. 7:50.
Looking up, taken into the boards by
right now. Sample stands his ground with Redmond, and then Shepherd has got things to say now. Crookshank and Maxwell will go dancing centre ice. Here we go. Everybody's left, and these two are going to go fisticuffs in the centre circle. Crookshank and Maxwell had words down in Basingstoke the other day, and here they go. Crookshank will try and grab on. He and Maxwell having a few words there. Crookshank trying to get free. And Maxwell tries a right. Crookshank gets one in himself. Good left there from Maxwell. They're trying to trade up, and a lot working on the inside here. A pair of them just trying to get loose here. Man, have they put a bit of a show on here as Maxwell tries to get one on the inside. Crookshank also with a little rabbit punch. Not much going on. The two of them tap backs and say that's it. They'll both be going and sitting down for 2 minutes apiece. I think Dennis Maxwell was trying to make a statement there. Be it to his side or the opposition. I think you can call that one a draw. A lot of show. Not a great deal of poke in the end from either fight. Thank you.
to the boards. The crowd like that one, and here they come. They're going to like this an awful lot more. Here's Marge with a shot just wide. Koenig unable to get hold of that. Oh, and down in front of us here, Darling and Payet have gone at it off the play. The chance for Panthers to take the lead was there, but the action was going on just down in front of us. Payet gets the takedown on Darling. Darling so long, the tough guy of the league. Well, Payet may be the new boy, but he's taught Darling something there.
So Morgan, 20 seconds to play.
He's done some good work on the balls, but hasn't been as much of an impact as I'm sure he would like to have been. Certainly is capable of doing as Petrico down there. Oh, crowd go crazy there. Petrico, perhaps a little bit of skate work as Myers is down, gets back up. He's clearly all right. Well, that move there really got the crowd going. And Petrico is tossed from the game with 11 seconds flat to play. Weaver sits the penalty.
A stretcher, please. Thank you.
Chirping and chiming going on right now.
starting now. This is almost a power play for the home side. They've got the support in the stands, and they got the puck. Now Phillips brings it out. Can't get the pass off cleanly. Wheaton sends it, but now we've got a battle between... Oh, that looks like sand. And Adams, some good blows coming in here from both of them. Sand has lost his helmet now. Adams has lost his helmet. Oh, it's still on there. Adams giving up a lot of height advantage. His visor saving him there, and he gets in a good blow. Well, perhaps a points victory to Adams. Perhaps a tie. What it's certainly done is get this already vocal Devils crowd on their feet and at an unprecedented volume.
Blaze back to full strength.